front of me. Let me see you lose yourself in a sexy dream. Tell me no lies with those soulful eyes. Show me how much you need.
Somebody understand that you are still worth value, and don't you devalue yourself because another person don't value who you are. Listen, and it amazes me how there are family members who will know that your mate is cheating, and they will uphold it and act like they love you. So I want to help people understand today, if people cheat on you, they don't value who you are. How could he hurt you? How could he treat you so? I want to help somebody today understand you are worth something. Sometimes you have to just sit back and say, wow. You probably say, why is she doing this video? I know y'all know the testimony, the story. You see me in my husband now, and you know, we smiling and we happy and all of that, and you know, that's wonderful, you know. But I just want to have a transparent moment. We ain't always been there, and that's why this song is so important to me right now. And let this video go viral, because I want people to understand, when y'all see me smiling and walking with my head up and encouraging others that you are worth something, I had to walk through this my own self. And I was real skeptical about going live. You know, I wrote about it in my book, Masking Behind the Mask. But I just want to encourage somebody today. You are worth something. You are worth something. And if you ever been in a place where your spouse has cheated on you, they didn't value who you are. They didn't value who you are. Or you in a relationship with somebody, they didn't value who you are. They didn't value your worth. You know, I'm good today, but I've been holding this for many, many years. And I just want to get this off my chest. Yes, I do love my husband. I do. You probably say, why is she telling all her business? Because it happened. It happened. It happened. It happened. It happened. And it takes prayer. It takes trusting God. It takes, you know, when you have a call on your life and you that hits you in your face, it's like a ton of bricks that has fallen upon you. And see, some people, they don't want to be transparent. They don't want to tell you that they went through that process. I'm going to tell you, it wasn't easy for me to get past this thing here. It wasn't. But I thank God today that I'm a whole woman and I know my value, and you have to know your value, whether you male or female. You have to know your value and you have to know your worth, you know. And I'm going to encourage somebody, because it may be somebody out there that's going through this right now that's saying, I'm going to go back in the world. I'm going to go cheat. I'm going to go get me somebody on the side. I'm going to, hey, forget it, you know. But I want to encourage you today, don't do that. Don't go back out and do the things that you did in the world because you have had this experience with your spouse cheating on you, you know. I want to encourage you today to pick up your head and walk in your faith with God and hold on. And if it's meant to reconcile, God will reconcile. Don't let anybody make you feel like you stupid because you stayed in a marriage where your spouse cheated. One of the most hurtful things for me was knowing that some of my in-laws would allow my husband to do his stuff and they was cool with it, you know. And today they smile, hey, cuz, hey, and we love you and all of that. But back then, they was watching him do his dirt, you know. And I'm the wife praying and, you know, believing God for my marriage and this. Now listen, don't misquote what I'm saying. This happened years ago. This is not happening now. This is not happening now. But I feel led to, good morning, to encourage somebody on this morning that God can reconcile marriages. He can, you know. But I'm not going to tell you that the process don't hurt. Because people, I'm not going to tell you that sometimes you don't feel stupid. That you don't feel like, is it worth it? You know, is it worth fighting for, knowing that your spouse, male or female, has cheated on you? I'm not going to tell you. You know, some people want to sweep stuff under the rug and mask it because we're in the church and all this. So, well, this happened while I was serving God. Okay? It did. It did. And you're probably saying, well, why is she putting her business out there? to help somebody know that God can reconcile marriages, okay? And that you can survive this. And what the enemy will do is try to come in from time to time, even though you have forgiven your spouse, and make you go back and relive some of those thoughts, you know. And that's the enemy working on you to make you say, you know what? Why am I still in this marriage? Why am I still in it? But can I tell you something? God can reconcile. God can restore, you know. And so I felt led to share that this morning because I don't know who it's for. Now, to the deep folks, you know, well, let me take that back, because my mentor been kind of just like, you know, trying to tell me to watch, you know, some of my delivery. And I'm really, really working on it because I'm trying not to offend people, even when I'm speaking the truth about something. So what I want to say is, allow God to heal you. Allow God, you know, if his will, to restore your relationship, if it can be resolved, allow the Father to do it. Thank you, sis. You know, but I felt led to share that because sometimes, you know, we go through that we're not good enough. You know, when your spouse has cheated on you, you go through you not good enough, and you don't look a certain way. I know for me, I had my sons, and you know, when I married my husband, I wasn't big. You understand what I'm saying? And when I had my sons, I went through depression. I gained a lot of weight. My self-esteem was out of the whatever, you know. And I didn't feel good about who I was. You know, I didn't know that I could still be beautiful being a big girl. You know, because all my life, if you look at my hands, I was small all my life. So having children and gaining weight sent me into depression. You understand what I'm saying? Because I lost my Coke bottle figure, you know. And so when your mate step out of the marriage, you wonder what, you know, I'm not good enough. Come on. I mean, people don't want to be real about that, but that's the way I feel. You know, this is not happening now. This happened 20 something years ago. Okay. So let me just clear the record. I just want to help somebody. When you see, you don't know what a person went through in their relationship to get to where they are. You understand what I'm saying? And yes, I was a praying woman. I was. But it still didn't stop it. It happened. Now, will I sit up in here and say that at one point I didn't get mad enough that I wanted to go out there? I'm not going to lie to you and say I didn't, because at one point I did. But what I want to tell you is that the Father kept me from going out there cheating on my husband. You do me, I do you. You understand what I'm saying? It was only God. I'm not going to tell you the thought did not cross my mind because I was hurt. I'm not going to tell you it didn't cross my mind. I'm not going to tell you that my heart wasn't bitter for a long time. I'm not going to sit up and lie and tell you that. So I don't know who this is for, male or female. But what I will tell you is this, is that I kept praying through the pain, and God helped me to love my husband again. Are you hearing me? So, and it could be you with your husband, or it could be with you with your wife. You understand what I'm saying? What I'm going to tell you as a believer, do not step outside of your marriage. Don't do it. Because what you're saying is that you don't trust God. And a lot of people, they don't want to talk about these issues and marriages. It's sad that we in the church and we cannot discuss infidelity. It's like you can't discuss none of that. Woo! You can't discuss none of that. Why? So that people can be healed and that they can be set free and that marriages can be restored. Why is it that we don't talk about everything is a secret? Everything is a secret. But you got to expose the enemy for who he is. Because the enemy comes in to destroy marriages and relationships. And so let me tell you something. If I have to keep putting my business on blast and it's helping one person, I'm going to keep doing that. And let me tell you something. If you are in marriages and you have friends and families that uphold your infidelity, they are full of it. They're doing no justice. They're doing no justice. And a lot of people, they do that. They uphold that wrong. They won't say it's wrong. I know people grown. But let me tell you something. I have a son who's married. He can't know. If him and his wife separated or something and he got him a boo thing, guess who he can't bring to his mama? He can't bring his boo thing to his mama. No, you still married. Go to your wife. If y'all can't make it, then that's a totally different thing. But ain't no boo thing coming nowhere where your mom at. Marriage is sacred. And we got to quit upholding this stuff. Then you got preachers. Let me go there. They traveling with people. And they cheating on their wives. They checking in hotels. They preaching the gospel. See, we don't want to talk about this here. Stop it. Don't tell me you can't be kept. Don't tell me that, because you can if you allow God to keep you. So it's real true for me. I ain't doing nothing for no likes. I want to see people be made whole. I want to see people be set free. This too was a part of my process. And today I'm sharing it because I'm a free woman. Ain't nothing finna hold me in bondage. No, absolutely nothing. And we better stop upholding this stuff and saying it's okay. It's not. It's not. It's not. So I had to set the record straight. This ain't happened now. This 20 some odd years ago. But I was saved. And a praying woman. So I had to make sure I clarify that. But I want some other person to be strengthened. And if you know that you want your marriage, fight for it. If you know that you want your marriage, fight for it. Don't let nobody make you feel stupid. You understand what I'm saying? I know me, I went into depression. I gained weight. I didn't care anymore. I was depressed, so I let myself go. Does that justify what happened? No. But if your spouse ain't in God like you are, it's a possibility it could happen. The only thing that kept me from going out there cheating It's because I had a relationship with God. Had not I not been where I was in God, I'm not going to lie to you. I probably would have cheated too. And people don't want to tell those type of stories. They want to make it look like, oh, that thought didn't rise. No, I would be lying to you if I didn't tell you that thought didn't cross my mind. That made me pray even the more. If you only knew how many days I was in the flow praying, saying, God, kill this flesh. Keep me under subjection, please. Because ain't no telling what would have happened. And that's why I try to tell y'all real life stories. Fight for your marriage. Let me tell you something. People make mistakes. None of us are perfect. And I'm sure I did things that probably pushed them out there too. I'm not justifying what happened. I'm not even making excuses for it. But I can tell you, I went through a depression and didn't care about myself. I would wear my hair in a ponytail all the time and put on scrubs. And if I wasn't in scrubs, I was in big sweatpants. So when you see me now, yeah, I got a swag. Oh, yes, I got a swag. Because I found my worth again and who I am. And now I'm loving who I am, even in my thick size. I'm loving who I am. But it wasn't always like that. And vice versa. If your spouse used to seeing you a certain way and then all of a sudden you let yourself go, whether you male or female, something else may start looking good. I'm not excusing anybody stepping outside of their marriage. I'm not excusing that because that's a hurtful place. But what I'm saying is, let us not push our mates out there. It's a hurtful place. We don't pay them no attention no more. My husband didn't understand me fighting depression. Because sometimes I was shut down, to be honest with you. But see, people not going to tell those sides. They only going to tell, they did this to me and they hurt me and this and that. But what did you do to play a and I'm not saying that's the case in all marriages. Because some people are just hoish. Just to be honest with you. But sometimes we can do things, male or female, to push them away or push them out there. And yes, we don't realize what we're doing sometimes because we're dealing with our own pain. It took me years, y'all, to fight depression, low self-esteem. You know, it took me years to get to where I am now that I'm confident and I'm comfortable in my thickness. Took me years to get here. You understand what I'm saying? So if sometime I'm putting up pictures and y'all probably say, every time you look around, she putting up pictures of herself. Well, you know what? It used to be a time I didn't want to take pictures of myself. I didn't. Because I was unhappy with who I was. So if you're in a relationship, you're in a marriage or in a relationship, it's worth fighting for. It's worth fighting for. You know, it's worth fighting for because look at you have to weigh out some things. You have to say, I remember on three occasions me having a near-death experience. I remember that. You know who was there? Bathing me when I couldn't bathe myself. Making sure I ate when I couldn't eat. My husband was. And sometimes I get angry, you know. sometime, you know, because my mind every now and then go back to certain things. It travel every now and then, maybe something that remind me of something. But I have to quickly say, devil, you a liar. We passed that. That's old stuff. That's not what's going on now. And you have to do that to yourself. Sometimes things can trigger something to make you go back to stuff that you and your mate have gotten past. Just some looks. It's the trick of the enemy to try to pull you back to a place that you're not in. Don't allow that either. I don't know who this is for, but I really want to help you stay free. And listen, if you went through that or if you're going through that now, okay, can I tell you, you keep God in your heart. You keep praying. Weigh the good things and weigh the bad things. Do the good, outweigh the bad. Are you hearing me? And then think about you as a person. What was your mate used to you doing that you stopped? That's why I tell people, you know, some of the stuff that you did when you first got married, you know, little stuff, continue to do it. Because our mates look for that. And when that is missing, it's like a void is missing. It's like a void is missing, you know, and I'm not ashamed. Blessing, sis. I'm not ashamed of the testimony. I'm not ashamed. Nobody's going to make me feel ashamed. And let me tell you something else. Don't compare your relationship to somebody else's because you see them posting and everything look glitz and glamour and all this old kind of stuff. You don't know what hell they going through behind the scene. The one thing that I did not do when we were going through that process is I did not try to fake like everything was okay because it wasn't. I didn't. Be careful of your surroundings. Be careful of people that you are in acquaintance with when you're going through your process of reconciliation with your mate. Be careful, be mindful. Because people, girl, boy, man, if I was you, them the wrong people. That's why they probably by themselves. If I was you, that's why you by yourself. Because here's the deal. God created marriages and unions. If he didn't, he wouldn't have made it happen. He wouldn't have made it happen. And so I'm just trying to encourage somebody on this morning. If you facing something right now in your marriage, fight for it. I don't care if it is infidelity. And that person has came and asked forgiveness and you forgiven them, male or female. Fight for your marriage. Listen, we all can make a mistake. The only thing that kept me from not doing it was God. But if your mate is not where you are spiritually, it's easy. You understand what I'm saying? It's easy sometimes. The fear of God is the one that say, no, you can't do no tit for tat. But I'm not going to tell you that the thought didn't cross my mind. I be lying to you. See, some people going to lie to y'all. Tell y'all, oh, I'm so saved. Shoot. When that happened, it didn't make me think. No, they lying to you. They lying. They may not have acted upon it, but in a hurt place, You want to get revenge. You want to get revenge. And what better way to get revenge? Do the same thing they did. Don't let nobody lie to you. It's only by the grace of God that I didn't step out. But I'm not going to tell you that the thought didn't cross my mind. Not going to lie to you. I'd be a lying one if I sit up and play that game with you. I ain't going to do it. I ain't going to do it. And I know people probably say, why is she putting her business out if that happened 20 years ago or over 20 years ago? Because it happened. And it's real. And I was saved and loving on God. And it happened. So how many people are saved and loving on God and facing this right now and saying, I want to give up. There's no hope. If a person truly have a heart of forgiveness and you see that they're trying, forgive them and move past it. And I know it's probably going to be a mockery or a laughing, you know, behind it. And I'm good with it if it helped one person to not step outside of your marriage and fight for your marriage. I promise you, if you give it to God and it's His will, your marriage is going to be better than what it was. Keep the love of God in your heart. And keep the love of God in your relationship. And you can overcome anything. And we don't talk about these things in the church because it's whatever's done in the dark, keep it in the dark. It's a big secret. It ain't no big secret. It ain't no big secret. Because guess what? Other people see them out there cheating. You may not see them at that moment. But other people, so it ain't no big secret. It's not. Who told y'all that? It ain't no big secret, honey. It's no big secret. You need to be healed so you can move forward. Let the enemy know, okay, I'm putting this on public glass. It happened. But I'm not walking around in shame because my marriage was worth fighting for. And guess what? Come October the 6th, we will be celebrating 31 years. So it was worth fighting for. Who am I talking to? And let me tell y'all something. A lot of these Christian marriages are going through the same thing, and we masking it instead of saying we got you and praying with people and walking with people. But what we're doing, we're making them feel like they're stupid from fighting for their marriage. No, I'm going to tell you, you are not stupid from having faith in God for reconciliation of your marriage. I'm going to tell you to trust God for your marriage. And anybody that speak curses against your union, that they be silenced. And anybody upholding and encouraging infidelity so they can have somebody to hang out with and do wrong, silence them too, Father. It's enough of it. And it's happening big time in the body. Preachers are upholding other preachers. They getting on planes with each other. And their wives or their husbands are at home. And they going talking about they preaching. But they're in infidelity. And don't nobody want to say nothing about it. Well, guess what? You can be kept. I know it because He kept me. So, I don't know what to tell you. but the truth. It says, whom the Son sets free is free indeed. And you're probably saying, she can't give us no wisdom on marriages. Oh yeah, I'm qualified for this one, honey. That's why I tell the good, the bad, the ugly, all of it. Because the enemy don't have nothing to play with me on. Nah. We are overcomers by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. This is a part of my testimony. You can be kept, and your marriage is worth fighting for. It's worth it. All right, so I love you guys. That's my, I guess, my fit for the kingdom for today. I love you guys. I'm out here. Blessings. Be blessed on today. Yes, I had to. That was like 20 years of kind of holding. That was a release, even for me. Yeah. Listen, fight for your marriage. I love you guys. Fight. Fight with the help of the Lord. All right? Blessings. I love you guys to life. Hey, sis. Hello, prophet. Hello. Hey, my sis, yoga. Hello. Blessings. I'm good. That was a 20-year release, sis. I was just led to do it. I've been battling. Should I talk about that for the last couple of days? And this morning, I got the release to share that testimony. But I had to tell people it was over 20 years ago so they wouldn't be like, oh, she going through, oh. You know how people are, you know, take it and run. So I had to make sure it was clarity over 20-something years ago. You know, we was young in the marriage. So I had to make sure that I clarified that. Yeah, I had to clarify that. So listen. I love you guys. Hey, sis. I love you guys to life. Be blessed. And like I say, it'll be 31 years, October the 6th. Fight for your marriage. It's worth fighting for. I know it's easy to walk away. People tell you, if I was you, I wouldn't take this. I would just. And that's why some of them buy their doggone self. Steal from relationship to relationship. Because I wouldn't take this. Instead of saying, God, wait a minute. Is it your will? Not my flesh. But is it your will? And if it's your will, then you do it. That way I know that it's from you. Because that's the prayer that I prayed. I said, Father, if this ain't for us no more, even after all of this, then take me out of it. And guess what? Every time I prayed that prayer, something happened that made us have to draw closer together. Something major. So guess what? I said, okay, Lord, you know, okay. Because every time I said, Father, if this marriage ain't for me and this is it, then I need you to get me out of this. I'm not gonna lie to y'all. That's what I prayed. And here we are, going on year 31, a marriage. We still together. So, it must be the Father's will. I got to keep praying, you know. So, what am I saying to you? Thank you, sis. I'm just trying to encourage a few folks. That's it. Trust me, this was hard for me to share. But I'm good. I just wanted to help somebody else because that was weighing heavy on me. And anytime something weighs heavy on me, it's a purpose for it, you know. And you ain't got to put that you're going through it here. If you want, good morning. If you want me to stand in the gap, you can inbox me. I'm not finna put it on Facebook talking about so-and-so-and going through so-and-so-and and I'm praying for that. No. We not finna do all that. We not finna, that ain't the way to do it. I'm just gonna believe God with you for restoration of your marriage. And I know I'm on it. I know I'm on it. So I had to share my own testimony and story so it could help somebody still believe that God can resurrect something from a dead place. All right? So I love you guys. Blessings on this morning. Bye-bye.